Just moments ago, Georgia's Republican governor signed a sweeping election overhaul bill imposing new restrictions on voting in the state. Joining us in the Situation Room, global human rights leader Martin Luther King III. Thank you for coming on. Look forward to hearing your reaction to this, about this bill the governor in Georgia, Governor Kemp, just signed into law. It's one of many efforts underway across the country to restrict voter access. What impact will this law have on voters in your state of Georgia?
Well, first of all, it's a very sad day for this state. It bodes to moving back to Jim Crow era kind of legislation. The impact certainly has the potential to reduce voters, particularly of color, who normally would have all voters would have a longer time to vote. I think there's something in that legislation that says you can't even bring somebody water. How inhumane can these legislators be? Starting, even though the governor didn't vote, he of course approved it by signing the legislation. It's not surprising. It's greatly disappointing that our state has gone in this direction. What it means is that people are going to have to be more vigilant. Black people, young people, older people, poor people are going to have to be even more vigilant. It's unfortunate that this trend is happening all across America and over 40 states across our nation. It used to be a time where if you called someone a racist, they would want to retreat. But now it seems to be in vogue and all right to be a racist. It's a sad day in America, quite frankly.
And you view that bill that he signed as a form of racism?
Excuse me?
And so you're saying that you view the bill that he signed as a form of racism?
Oh, absolutely. There's no other reason. Why would you put something in place? You said we had a great election back in January, on January 5th. And of course, last year in November, there were no flaws or anything. So why would you restrict? We're supposed to be expanding the right to vote to make it easier for more people to vote, not restricting the right to vote. It's a travesty. It's tragic. And I think voters, maybe this is going to backfire. The hope is that more and more people will vote because they've made it so much more difficult by what they've done, which should be unconstitutional. And when you think about the fact we lead the nation and the world in promoting democracy, but we're blocking democracy at home. It's a sad day in Georgia and a sad day for America.
I want to get your thoughts on what we heard from President Biden today. He said he agrees with former President Obama that the filibuster is a relic of the Jim Crow era. You wrote about the filibuster in a new op-ed for CNN.com called, "This is what my father would have done." So what would your father have done about this?
Well, number one, perhaps there would have been additional mobilization efforts before it got to this particular point. And in fact, I would say if my father had lived, we would probably be dealing with different issues, not the issues that we're dealing with right now. But right now, the only thing that we can do is to mobilize and to organize and to get more and more people registered. And when the voting starts, to vote immediately. Those are the only provisions that I'm aware of. Now, the final provision, maybe if the Senate passes, you know, S1, which is being talked about, and Senator Schumer and Senator Klobuchar and many others are on board to do that. If that happens, some of this will be addressed.
I want to get
and the John Lewis Voting Rights Act.
Very quickly, I want to get your reaction to what Cindy Hyde Smith said about voting on Sunday, basically saying that you shouldn't be able to vote on Sunday because that's the day to praise God.
Everybody has their opinion, is what I would say. I think that in the communities of color and many other communities, after church, souls to the polls. People are led to the polls because we can praise God all the time and go to church on Sabbath day, but also we can participate in the government.
Okay. Martin Luther King III, thank you so much for that.
Thank you.